They get all bloodshot too. I get that genetically from my dad too. Thanks, Dad. He always had bloodshot eyes. Today, show's here. And Brady being all good. Hey, buddy. Think you're gonna do the show today? I wish you could go, buddy. I wish you could go. I think you're whatever about that. Hey, boy. So, here I weighed in this morning, 189. See if we can get a right about where I want it to be at. Hard, dry, a lot fuller. I'm actually bigger than I was last year at Team Universe. So this is probably, honestly, the package I should have brought last year at Team U. I'm still not as big as I need to be for the national level, but I have a bigger, fuller look for this one. And what I do is usually I go by like the way my shorts fit, where my shorts are kind of loose and I can get them on. Like when I started prepping for this, like they're a little bit loose right now here. When I first started prepping, I could barely get them over my legs 4 weeks ago. Now they like slip right on and they fit perfectly like, you know, when on stage. So I had hard-boiled eggs this morning with pineapple for my first, and it's not even a meal. I had a couple of hard-boiled eggs, or like I had one hard-boiled egg and like a few pieces of pineapple. And I'll eat as I kind of need to going up to the show. So we're going to head out of here, go to check-ins, athletes meeting, and then 10 o'clock the show starts. So let's go.
Getting nervous at all?
No. There's like no pressure on this show whatsoever. Like it's just not, you know, like Team Universe, I put so much pressure on myself. I mean, you were still, man, I almost cracked like how many times?
Mm-hmm.
Like I was like, I have to turn pro, I have to, that's all that mattered to me was like turning pro. And I don't know, you know, now it's just about competing. So, you know, if there's people, I guess, going to be there that I know from like around the gym and stuff competing. So it's like, you have to kind of, you know, socialize and stuff with them. Do the show, support the local NPC, which now I'm a Virginia resident, so my license says so now.
You're from the South.
From the South, even though it says fucking female on my license.
You got it fixed.
If you guys didn't watch that fucking Insta snap, Insta story that I did, I got my new Virginia license and they mail it to me. I look over everything and it says fucking sex, female. Like, I got like this fucking thick beard in the picture. I'm like, so I go back to the DMV, wait again, and they're like, oh, sorry, hit fucking another ticket, and sit down and fucking get it taken care of. But now that I'm a Virginia resident, you know, I support the local NPC. And then, like, I do the interviews with the ones for Rich Siegelman and those guys. So, you know, this is the only show in the area that I would be able to do. All the other ones I have to kind of work at. So, just kind of made sense. It's close to home, no hotel, no traveling. Like, you know, that stuff stresses me out just as much as the show. Like, we gotta take a flight somewhere or drive somewhere and check in, and like, it just, that shit's stressful to me. So I actually slept last night. I slept about 3 or 4 hours after you went to bed.
Yeah.
Like, I fell asleep on the couch. It's actually pretty comfortable on that sheet. The couch, I was like, it's more comfortable than just laying on the couch.
Guys, I went to bed and I took Brady with me so he wouldn't lick off his tan.
Yeah, because he went after my knee. I got a little spot in my knee.
Do you?
Yeah, it's like a little fucking, it's like a tongue spot on my knee. I was like, God damn it.
Drive-by licking. Like, ran by, licked his leg, and then kept running. We're like, what the hell,
he'll never
Brett?
Notice that. Yeah, he does it. Like, he'll run by, like, on the way by, he, like, licks it. He keeps going, so you can't even, like, stop him from licking you because you don't even know he's going to do it.
He's fucking with
he's
you.
He's running around you, and he just sticks his head out and licks you on the way by and keeps going.
He's a total clown.
He'll run by licking. And then, and it's not that I don't care. I care about the spot. I don't want the fucking protein in his mouth. Like, I don't know if this shit's poisonous. You're not supposed to drink it, you know? Like, I guess if you put it on your skin, it absorbs so it's not toxic. But, I mean, I don't know what the fuck. The dog's going to shit and smell like protein or something.
We got his tan on last night, and I said, hey, what the hell do we do with this super, super clingy dog? He's like, fuck, I don't have a clue.
Because he lays right against me, and, like, he won't. While we were putting the tan on, we put the gate up so he couldn't get in the bathroom. And he fucking stayed there at the gate, and he whined and whined. He could see us. He was watching us, but because he couldn't be 2 inches near us, he was whining the whole time, which made it tough to put the tan on, because you're like, Brady, it's fine, you know, he's never seen this shit before. Like, when we had him at the Team U, we went to the hotel in New Jersey, so he's never seen any of this shit before, he's never smelled those smells before. He was fucking not happy last night.
He probably thought I was hurting you.
Well, because she'd hit me with the tanning stuff, and it's cold, I go, ah!
And he was like, cold, oh my god!
Oh my god, she stabbed him! With the foam applicator, she stabbed him, oh my god.
Pretty dangerous, babe.
Okay. Number 124 and number 207 and 124. And now, Men's Physique over 35. We have seen some of these gentlemen already. We have not seen, and so please help me welcome 202 Jerry Ward.
I can't breathe. I gotta show them I can't get it in. 40s, number 48, number 49, number 65, number 202, and number 207. Turn to the back, please. And face front. And 202 and 48 switch, please. And one more time, turn to the back, please. And face front. Face the back one more time, please. And face front.
I'm overseas at about 100 G's for show. Don't test me, boy. Cause I rap with the best of show.
Alright, thanks guys. You can turn to your right and follow off.
Came off stage, and you know, those of you who like to make fun of the older guys, I think that the older guys had more conditioning than the younger guys.
Dude, they look sick.
Like I'm really impressed. Like when we started to line up, I mean, I was like, man, you know, for you know, 35 and over, the guys are sharp. 40 and over, and then there's a 50 and over class that was after us, and those guys are sharp too. Like except for the gray hair on them, like, if they shave their heads, you really wouldn't know these guys were over 50 years old. So the goal was to come in and be competitive. I don't know, I was the first call out in the 40 and over. There was only one call out in the 35 and over. Let's see where it falls, but it doesn't really matter at this point. It was a 3-week prep and exactly where I wanted to be. I'll have to check the footage to see if my posing and stuff was on point, just to make sure that I didn't lose points due to posing. And I'm sure my color was on point. My color's always good, so that's it. So now we're gonna go eat and come back at 4 o'clock for the meeting. We get an athlete meeting, which they basically just tell us, you know, good job, et cetera, stuff like that. And then it's over. So that's it. I mean, I probably had a better time at this one than, I mean, definitely better than I had at Team U.
You're so relaxed, yeah. And you're just happy. Like, there's a peace about you, though.
There's no pressure. Like, I'm not doing this for, you know, I didn't put, like, something on the line to be like, I have to do this because.
Right.
It was like, you know, as I mentioned in these vlogs, I mean, I did it because of my dad. I did it because I needed to prove some stuff to myself. I did it to know whether or not I could put my body in shape to be competitive in 3.5 weeks. Like I did, there's so many things going into it. It wasn't about like first place trophy, pro card. It wasn't about that, you know, like this time. I think that, you know, getting older with this shit, you gotta kind of move from the trophies. Like I told Aaron, I was like, look, I'm probably get trophies today. Like we can just fucking leave them at the venue. And she just kind of laughed. And I was like, seriously, like I have trophies sitting in storage that I don't even know what the fuck, what am I gonna do with them? You know, it's not about that anymore. When I was younger, it's all it was about. It's the only thing it was about was bringing home something. And now it's not what it's about. I mean, I met a bunch of cool people here today that, you know, have pictures of up on Instagram that we took and that'll see this. And you guys know who you are. Thanks for stopping me and saying what's up and had conversations and stuff. And, you know, Johnny, who owns Fresh Prep, you know, I follow him on Instagram. He follows me. And we get to compete against each other. His first show, we're competing against each other. So it's like, two local guys, you know, kind of doing our thing. It's pretty cool. So I had a good time.
You look great. I'm so proud of you.
I appreciate it.
You're so relaxed. It was neat to see.
Yeah, it was fun. You know, it was all about having fun this time. So I didn't feel overly depleted. I felt a lot bigger than I was last year. Like, I definitely feel like I woke up at 189 this morning. Mm-hmm. That's up from 184 the other day. And I think it was 186 carb up yesterday. So I got that extra weight back, cut my water last night, cut the water later than I normally cut it, which I think helped keep me a little bit fuller, a little bit longer. So let's go grab something to eat and get that.
We have three competitors we have not seen yet, so it's my pleasure to introduce to you number 202, Jerry Ward. Number 124, Pondo Walker. Number 207, Michael Warren. And now the rest of the competitors in the men's physique over 35 class. We have six competitors in this class, so please bring six trophies. Please take the sixth place trophy too. Number 207, Michael Warren. Thank you, Christy. Fifth place award goes to number 124, Pondo Walker. Pondo, right on the other side on the fifth place award. There you go. Fourth place goes to number 87, John Lee. In third place, number 202, Jerry Ward. Second place award goes to number 49, Richard Robichaud. And your winner, number 54, Apolabi Olulofin. Thank you guys.
the outcome that I was hoping for. I got a third in the men's 35 and over, 40 and over. I got beat by better guys, plain and simple. There's no politics involved. There's no bitching, complaining. When you get beat by better guys, you get beat by better guys. There's no shame in that. There's nothing wrong with that whatsoever. So, you know, I'll take my two trophies, which, really, honestly, they don't really mean that much. You know, it was a matter of getting here to the stage today. I'll be honest with you, in that 40-plus, just making the first call out, when they called my number, I was actually relieved. Because I saw the other guys, and I was like, fuck, these guys are good. And I talked to a few of them backstage. They had been to Masters Nationals, North Americans. They were national-level competitors. So automatically, in my head, I was like, oh, shit, like these guys are on the next level, where I got my ass kicked at Team Universe. And I held my own, you know, against those guys, which, you know, that when all was said and done, I was like, shit, you know, the fact that I was actually being moved around and compared to the guys, you know, felt pretty good. So we're gonna leave here, go grab something to eat. Shredded in 30 is done.
What are we gonna eat?
I don't know. I mean,
are you always asking, what are you gonna go eat?
I had a burger, but you know, I'm really not craving. This happens after shows all the time. I'm not craving anything.
Yeah.
I don't really want anything because I had the burger in between shows, which I think, you know, it did ruin my condition a little bit. To be honest with you, I think I was holding a little more water tonight, but I wasn't judged, so it didn't really matter. I probably overdid the salt on like the condiments and shit that I was eating it. And I'll bet you the Diet Coke had something to do with it too, when I drink that stuff in between water. So, yeah, I don't know. I mean, anything sounds good right now. You know, like just getting a shower and getting oil and stuff off seems like the biggest thing. But, you know, it wrapped up in 3.5 weeks.
That's incredible. You did it in 3.5 weeks.
3.5 weeks.
Most people are doing 4 months.
The idea was to be competitive. You know, like you win or lose. I mean, if you win today, like I told you, like there's a guy that walked through back here. Whoever won the overall today was just lucky this guy didn't compete. He was coaching someone else.
Oh, yeah.
If he competed, the whole outcome would have been different. Whoever won the overall would have been. There's always someone sitting in the crowd that can beat you. There's always someone who didn't compete today that can beat you. Just because you win doesn't mean that you're the best in the world. It means that you were the best that day that showed up. And somebody better than you didn't show up. So, you know, I'm going to leave these, I don't know, at home somewhere. I mean, they're a little bit different.
They're trophies you never, ever expected you would ever hold again.
Yeah, I didn't think I'd compete
in
again.
So that makes them kind of special.
You know, so what makes it special, these are for Dad. This whole thing was about Dad. It was to get me focused, and yeah, these are for Dad.
Yeah. So, all right. Let's see.